Aston Martin vanquish Zagato shooting brake finishes a quartet Q would envy. From A to Z in 4 steps, that being Aston Martin and Zagato, connected by carbon fiber links known as the vanquish Zagato coupe, Volante, Speedster, and the now official shooting brake. When the automaker revealed the Zagato Speedster at Pebble Beach in August, the shooting brake remained a sketch. Today we get honest, photographic proof of what 99 future owners will soon park in their climate-controlled display spaces. Were it not for the objet d'art reverence paid to a Zagato and the Bitsy production run, we'd expect to see the shooting brake frolicking through expensive enclaves just as often as a Ferrari GT4 Lusso. Aston Martin's 580-horsepower V12 provides useful intent up front, a luxuriously trimmed rear cabin area with tailored luggage carries its weight in back. In between, driver and passenger revel in a herringbone carbon fiber fascia, anodized bronze dials, quilted leather, and glass inlay for the double bubble roof inviting lots of light. The shooting brake goes into production next year, alongside the Speedster. As with the first three Bijoux, every shooting brake has already found a home. When Aston Martin hands the last set of keys to the final buyer, these 325 special editions will mark the close of another chapter in an Anglo-Italian cooperation begun with the 1960 DB4 Zagato.